All right. Welcome back, everybody. Sports Chat 503. Thank you guys very much for watching. First time, long time. Either way, I appreciate it. Coming live from Portland, Oregon. It's Monday, people. Just watched Monday Night Football, both games. And got to talk about this little controversy we've got going on in Oregon here. Tomorrow, we've got our live stream. If you guys are interested in joining the live stream, 5 o'clock Pacific Coast time on Tuesdays. Throughout the entire year, we're doing this. Live stream Tuesdays. If you guys are interested in joining, sports.chat.503@gmail.com. If you want to join in, if you want to just sit back and listen, great. If you want to chat online, we're going live at 5. Okay, so we got to talk about this. So video comes out of the student section, part of the student section, chanting F the Mormons. And not a good look. Now, at the same time, you got to understand something. I'm just going to preface this by saying, first and foremost, I do not support this. I support general razzing at games. I support young kids getting intoxicated and having fun at games or whatever. When I say young, I mean college kids. But there's less creativity involved with that, and I'm not really that big of a fan of how that looks in the stadium. But I got to go back and tell you a little bit about how this goes. Now, first and foremost, I didn't hear any of this in the stadium. I sit across from the student section. I'm in 34. They're on the other side. I didn't hear any of this during the game. I have heard numerous times from our section a wide variety of FU insert team name here. Now, the problem here is with Mormons rather than Cougars. Had they just said FU Cougars, no one's got a problem. No one's saying anything here. But because you have the religious connotation, because it looks like derogatory language toward a religion, it involves a completely different thing. I grew up Irish, Catholic. My family's Irish. I'm not from Ireland. I'm from Portland, Oregon. From Eugene, Oregon, Portland. But my family's Catholic. I went to Catholic school. My family's Irish. Our family has Irish traditions to go back, right? So if we're playing Notre Dame and they say, would they say FU Catholics or would they say FU, you know, Notre Dame? How would you go about that? So I just looked at it from a variety of different levels. Now, I don't condone the behavior at all, and I deeply regret that people were offended by that in the stadium because, again, the one thing that I really appreciate about BYU is they're family-oriented. They bring the family with them. There's other kids there. It's not an appropriate situation to be hearing that in the stadium by a variety of different people chanting that. I'll just say that straight up, and I'm not afraid to say that. That's what it should be. There's a certain amount of decorum you should have. I also, though, as a former player and as a coach, you know, I love sportsmanship. I love, absolutely love to play as hard as I could. I talked a lot of junk between the lines. I got as into it as possible. I was very intense as a player and as a coach. Towed the line numerous times as a coach in my past, and I really respect that, but I tend to think you should take a little bit of a step back as a fan, and you got to represent the university, you got to represent the rest of your fan base, and it looks like we're all being kind of glommed into one group here, and that's really not the case, and a lot of BYU fans know that, obviously, but it's a small group who's chanting this, and they're chanting this every week. It's not specific to BYU. I think that's the big thing about why I wanted to come out and just say this, because not like I in any way, shape, or form represent the university. I am just one guy out here doing things on YouTube, but just like with anything, this is the platform I have, so I'm going to say my piece on the thing, and just to understand that, obviously, the entire fan base does not think like this, and it was not also intended to be derogatory explicitly toward the religion. You do understand that the West Coast is more liberal. You do understand that there's a real extreme liberalism, especially in Eugene, Portland, the metropolitan areas. But the rest of the state is fairly conservative. The rest of the state, as soon as you step out of Eugene or Portland boundaries, basically, you're in a conservative area that would also represent and reflect the same values that you would have in Utah. And so, you know, not to get political on here or whatnot, but I am a social studies teacher. You know, I come from the angle of respect all, right? And especially in a college sporting event environment. I was watching Twitter last week, and I saw a bunch of stuff on Twitter that I felt like was over the line. But I get it. People are in an extreme mode. People go with the nameless, you know, anonymous, you know, kind of look where they can say whatever they want. And no one knows who they are. And I obviously do not have that. I've got a level of accountability here and as a public figure, as you know, for who I am and where I go and what I do. And I need to kind of be able to be respectful of a lot of different people. And I personally am. I personally politically am right down the middle. I try to be very independent in my thinking. I also try to be very independent in my thinking about religion. I grew up in Catholic school, but I'm not a practicing Catholic. I don't embrace religion that much in my own life, but I have very, very close, near and dear friends who I love very much, who are very passionate about their religion. And I respect that just as much as I'm a Second Amendment guy, and I'm not going to own a gun. And I'm not a gun owner, and I still respect and support the Second Amendment. It's just kind of one of those deals. So this was a situation, you know, that kind of leaned political, you know, and it kind of leaned religious very quickly. And I don't know if that was the original intention, but obviously don't condone it. And it's a bad look coming off that win, because that win was such a great win. It was such a great day. It was such a perfect opportunity for the Ducks. The fact that we had to somehow screw the thing up in some way, shape, or form, you know, kind of pisses me off a little bit, because you came off that thing so beautiful, and now you got to deal with this. And now I'm getting letters in my email, you know, from the new interim president. You know, we're in this like kind of communication mode where we're apologizing, the pit crew's apologizing. I mean, where are we at right now? And so I think it's warranted, but I also don't think we need to even get there to begin with. I think, you know, football games are intended to be fun, but you know, these kids are college kids. They do not represent you personally in your life personally. And a lot of people, I feel like, get a lot out of the going to these games for their own ego, that they can go the rest of the week and show off to their friends or something, and you know, whatever the case may be. I don't know. But, you know, I love the Oregon Ducks very dearly, and I respect the players on the field, and I want to represent as much as possible for our fan base. So I go out of my way to try to welcome opponents, fan bases into Autzen. I thank them for coming. I hope they have a good day. As a guy who's gone to a lot of bowl games in my life, I've always been a very gracious person on that level and say good luck, have fun. And I just think that really is what's needed. I've heard from people numerous times, man, you're a great Duck fan. I don't ever, you know, and like they haven't been able to have many good interactions. That's sad to say. Now, there's a lot of great Duck fans, and when we travel, I think we do a really good job. But obviously, I felt like we just needed to come on and say some stuff about that, because it was just a crazy situation. It's a situation that I would deal with, you know, in my classroom. It's kind of one of those things where it's like it's a disciplinary thing. It's a learn moment, you know, and you got to move past it. But, you know, I do think the apology was warranted. So, sorry about that, BYU fans. The other level is we got an 8 a.m. kickoff for this Stanford game, and people are absolutely out of their minds complaining about the 8 p.m. They might give us an 8 a.m. We don't even know. In the future, we'll be playing on Telemundo. Well, no, the 8 p.m. game, it's not ideal, but if it's only one game throughout the year, it's manageable. The problem is when they stack them up night after night after night, and you just get buried, and every night you're in the late spot, which I don't think is going to happen. So, you know, one night, that's fine. Stanford, it gets weird with Stanford. Pac-12 after dark, they obviously want that. FS1, they want that. So, you know, it's fine. It is a rough night for everybody who travels from out of town, and a lot of the Duck fans do. It used to be that I would say probably half of the stadium was from Eugene. And I would say now that under maybe a quarter of the stadium is from Eugene on any given Duck game. And maybe that number is skewed. I don't have any sort of data on that. But a lot of people come from Portland. A lot of people come from Bend. A lot of people come up from Medford or come from the coast. But there's a lot of people on the highways. And that's a late night. You know, I'll get back to Portland at probably 2 in the morning. maybe even 3 in the morning if there's tons of traffic, if that game goes late, like those Stanford games have in the past, and it gets real close toward the end, everybody stays. That makes it even worse. But, you know, it's just one of those things. You got to bite the bullet and do it. It's a fun atmosphere when you get the late game. It's just the 8 o'clock is just 1 hour later. And the 7 o'clock start is already late enough. 8 is a real late one. So, yeah, I understand why people complain about it, but it is what it is. You know, we got to get through it. So it'll be fun under the lights, tailgating under the lights even. I mean, people won't even be over there. The sun's going to be setting at 7 o'clock now. So, oh, man, it's just a crazy situation. But it'll be fun to see what they do this week, and then it'll be fun to see what they do next week. All right, tomorrow, Sports Chat Live. Let's get it in. We can talk about any of the stuff from the BYU game, the chants from the student section if we need to cover that. Obviously need to get your homework done on the Wazoo tape. The Wazoo tape looks pretty good. Their defense is fast. So it's just going to be a fun week this week. If you guys are going up to the game, have fun. Safe travels up in the Palouse. I was going to pull that trigger. Now I'm not. I'm staying here. Might even go to the beach. We'll see about how that goes. But should be a great weekend for everybody. And I'm absolutely thrilled. Just too bad we have this kind of negativity and, you know, controversy. It's just one more thing for Fox News to add to the list of Sodom and Gomorrah about the West Coast and Oregon and how it's still on fire and Antifa and everything else. Now we don't even respect people at a football game. All right, guys. Thanks for watching Sports Chat 503. We'll see you guys next time. Adios.